Hello, I am Dr. Satish Babu, Senior Consultant ENT and Head and Neck Surgeon, presently working with the Apollo Hospitals in Bangalore. In children, yes, isn't it a good thing that children gain weight? And as parents, are we not happy that they gain weight? Especially after a tonsillectomy, when they've had problems all through, they have not been eating well, and then they start gaining weight. Right? When there is an obstruction, when there is a problem with the tonsils, obviously the child is not eating well, right? For many reasons. And the child will not also be gaining weight appropriately to the age. The reasons could be a physical or mechanical obstruction by the sheer size of the tonsil, right? And the second thing is presence of adenoids most of the times along with the tonsils, which leads to an obstruction to the breathing, nasal breathing will get obstructed, and because of that the baby has to breathe through the mouth, hold your breath while you are chewing your food, whereas a normal person would be continuing to breathe while chewing the food. Whereas if the nose is blocked, then you have to do both breathing as well as chewing the food through the mouth, and that's why the need to hold the breath while chewing the food. For an adult, holding the breath for 10 to 15 seconds is not a big thing, but for a small child it's going to be a problem, and that leads to them not eating comfortably. Of course, an obstruction to the nose will lead to probably the reduction in the smell sensation, which reduces the appetite. Throat also gets dried up when you breathe through the mouth, as we all experience during a cold. This dryness leads to small issues like loss of taste sensation, right? Stickiness in the throat. And of course, food not going down smoothly because of the roughness due to dryness, right? These things will, happen when the adenoids are swollen. Of course, tonsils and adenoids being swollen means that they are getting infected also frequently. Sickness because of the infection as such will lead to loss of appetite as well, right? Again, frequent infections will require frequent usage of medications, be it antibiotics or anything else, leading to problems related to the medicines as well, right? Again, causing a problem in weight. Again, children with regular infections have chronic cough issues, right? They keep coughing all the time, especially if they cough immediately after taking food and medicines, they vomit out the whole thing. Right, more so in smaller children this happens, and the children who are breathing through the mouth or blocked nose, they tend to have a very very hyperactive kind of a daytime as compared to an adult who has a nose block and couldn't sleep properly in the night, would rather feel more sleepy in the daytime and not active. The children on the other hand will become more active, so they burn out more calories being more active, and they sometimes are branded as hyperactive children. All these things lead to the baby not gaining weight or not being healthy. Now once we do the surgery, once the obstruction is cleared, child is definitely better. He is able to breathe while chewing. Naturally the health is going to be better, and the weight is also gaining properly, and would probably reach appropriate to the age. The only thing we should be cautious about is not to overfeed them in the post-operative period.